Now we will discuss a lecture of anatomy. Is something related to general anatomy. One of the basic topic, you know, which is known as bone marking or bone surface modification, also sometimes called as bone landmarks. Do you have any idea what is actually bone markings or bone surface modifications? Anyone have any idea? You know what? Any bone of your body have some prominence or some projections, some depressions, some hole on their surface. What? Bones. Do you know this word can understand much better? Bone surface modification. That means the surface of the bone is modified. The surface of the bone is. What are these modifications are actually? If you look generally, you have three things. Number one, these modifications, you have three things. One, there should be a projection, bony projection. What? Bony projection. Number two is a depression. Number two is a bony depression. Third, you have holes. What have? Holes are opening or openings in the bone. Opening in the bone. You know what? Let's take example. If you look on this bone roughly here, so there we have many projections, many, you know what, depressions and some openings here. You can look in this bone. But point is that up to now, bone surface modifications, bone marking is mean a bone, a normal bone have many projections, bony projection, depressions and what? Openings are holes. All bones of your body show these different characteristics. They may have some projection, they may have some depression, they may have some openings. So these modifications may be developed during the development of the body, development of the bone, during the embryology. But these modifications actually are known as what? Bone marking. This is what bone marking are. Bone marking are what? Bone projection, depressions and opening. Point number two. Why bones have bone marking? Why bones have bone marking? This is something is important. Because your bones are actually associated with muscles. Associated with muscles. Your bones are covering what? Many internal organs. So there is a combination in your whole body. If you look on your skeleton or skeleton of animals, they are living in a relationship. They are living in a many other structures. They are passing on from the bones. They are associated with the bones. They have relation with skeleton. For that purpose, you know, bone projections are normally, mostly they are involved in what? They are involved in joint formations. Two bone projections, they are involved in joint formation. Why we need bone marking? Number one, for joint formation. Number two, there is many skeletal muscles, they are directly attached on bones. Directly attached on bone. For that attachment, we also need what? Bone marking. You need for bone marking for what? Joint formation. For muscle attachment, for ligament attachment. Number third, many blood vessels, many nerve vessels are passing from the bones. For passing from the bones, we need bone marking. And a long bone or big bone, you can say, they have itself their own blood vessels and nerve vessels. These blood vessels and nerve vessels enter into the bone from that hole or from that opening. So listen again carefully. Two things are important. Number one, what are bone marking? bone marking are the surface modification, could be a three kinds: bone projection, depression on bone, or what? A opening on bone. Okay, next, why the bone have bone surface modification or bone marking? Why? Because they provide attachment to muscles and ligaments. They help in joint formation. They help in joint formation, for joint formation, for muscle attachment, and they also provide a way, a passage to blood vessels and nerve vessels. That's clear. Okay, you know, these every bones have its own bone marking. Some are common, some are very specifics. Some are very specifics, mean only located on one bones. You know what? These bone marking have different name. So if you look on little on functionally, what activity they are doing, in what activity they are involved, so you can classify bones into three groups. Bone markings into three groups. So these three groups are: one, number one is articular markings. Articulation bone marking mean those bone marking which are involved in joint formation. Articulation mean articular marking mean articulation. Articulation mean what? Joint formation. Articulation mean what? Joint formation. Joint formation. Clear? Number two. First we have class which one? Joint formation or articular marking. Number two is muscle ligament marking. That means actually this is muscle ligaments attachment. What? Attachment. So meaning is that these bone markings are involved, they help to attach muscles with bones. There is the area where muscles are actually fixed with bone. Third one is what? We have some depressions and foramen. The word foramen means hole, opening in the bone. So these are actually depressions and openings. These are actually what? Depression and openings in the bone. Opening the bone. That's clear?
Yes.
So, one, you know, another classification if you can buy, want to make, you can make other, it's called other bone markings. Means some bone marking which could not classify in these classes. They are only two. One is neck and other is body. They are common or normal bone markings which are not including in any groups. Okay? You know what we are going to do? We are going to look on each bone marking to have an idea how they look like and where they are present. So first come on to the articular marking or articulation marking, those bone marking which are involved in joint formation. Number one is head. Number one is, you know, head is actually what? This is mostly located on the end of the long bone, mostly on the proximal end of the long bone, but they are hard and round in shape. This is hard, okay, and round in shape. And definitely they are involved in the formation of what? Joint formations. You know, best example of for this is what? Head of femur. Head of, here we have baby, this femur bone, this one, okay? Look here, this structure is what? This is the head of, this is a femur bone, okay? So this is a projection. This is a bony projection. This is what? Bony projection. But this structure is involved in the joint formation. This head of femur is actually fixed with what? Hip bone here. For example, we have this like this. You know this hole fixed here to form what? Hip joint, yes. To form? Point is that this bone marking is known as what?
Head.
This is present in, this is a proximal end of long bone. This is a proximal end of long bone. So this is what? Head. Round and hard. Okay? Similarly, look here. This is a humerus. Humerus also have head. This head fits with the glenoid cavity of the scapula to form a joint. That's clear. If you go forward, the next term is known as condyle. They are also round and blunt shaped structure. Look here. This one. These structures are actually known as what? Condyle. They are known as condyles. It's two condyles. They are two condyles. They, you know, if this is a femur, definitely. Next we have here what? Tibia fibula. We have next what? Tibia. So the formation of joint between tibia fibula and femur is helped by or facilitated by condyles. So these are condyles, and other bony projections are which are involved in the formation of joints. That's clear. They are, these condyles are what? They are on mostly distal end. They are blunt. They are blunt and semi-round shape. That's clear. The next one is facet. You know, this facet is what? This is somehow a projection, a area is involved in the formation of joint. But point is that these two areas were round. These are two were? But this one is flat. This one is? Flat surface. Flat surface. If you look here, if we have a vertebrae here, yes, we have. Maybe, if you look here, this one, here, we have what? A flat, two flat areas. Look on back side with the body here. We also have two flat, here also we have flat areas. These flat areas are actually helped to attach other vertebrae with this in vertebral columns. And also if this vertebrae belongs to the thoracic cavity, they also provide help to the attachment of ribs with the vertebrae. So they are involved with the joint formation. Point is that this facet is actually a flat surface, articulating surface, but flat in shape. And best example is we have in vertebrae. That's clear? Okay, next we have trochlea. Trochlea actually a pulley-like structure. You know what in physics, pulley? You may know that. This is what? This is pulley-like structure. This I believe available on humerus, if we have humerus here. Look here. Pulley, you know pulley, P-U-L-L-Y, this is physics to do some mechanical work is helping, you know, common in industry. So if you look here, this structure is actually what? It's pulley-like. This is known as trochlea. Why this is called as trochlea? Because they are, its structure is like pulley and is involved from where? Which bone attached will be here? Radius and ulna. Here, this one, okay? So, this is, you know, pulley do what? Pull something. So, look here. What is going on here? You are understanding this point?
Yes, sir.
So, point is that this structure is what? Trochlea is the bone marking which is available on distal end of humerus. Must remember this. Okay? Next one is glenoid cavity. Glenoid cavity is actually a depression. Actually what? Depression. But this depression is involved in the formation of joint. That's why we have included this in articulated marking. For example, if we have here scapula. Yes, we have. This, you know, this is distal end. This structure is known as what? This is known as glenoid cavity. So this glenoid cavity, this femur is big one, you know, actually attached with the head of femur. This maybe belong to goat. This scapula belongs to goat. So this is no, what? You can observe. This surface is actually have a depression. This surface have a depression. But still this surface is what? articulatory surface, a joint forming surface. Which surface? Joint forming surface. That's clear. So this is what? Glenoid
cavity.
Okay. So listen here again carefully. Take it easy.
These are few examples of what?
Articulating bone markings. Articulating bone markings.
We have head, we have condyle, facet, trochlea, glenoid cavity.
So there is a some structural difference, and there is also a difference. They are located on different bones.
Okay.
For example, head, you know, this is a hard, a prominent surface. Maybe if you feel this is a little smooth, especially in the case of humerus. So head is actually located on the proximal end of femur and humerus. Proximal end of femur and humerus.
Number two is a condyle. This is a blunt.
Okay. And semi-round type, a big, you know, two condyles are located on the where? On the distal end of femur.
Next, we have facet. The difference between head and condyle, the facet is a flat surface. This is all are articulated surface, but they are round. But this one is the
flat surface. They are very flat surfaces are located on vertebrae.
Okay. Next is the trochlea, is a pulley-like structure which is found on
distal end of humerus. Distal end of
humerus. The glenoid cavity is what?
This is a you know, like a cavity with have a depression on distal end of what? Scapula, known as glenoid cavity of scapula, which help in the formation of joint of scapula with what? With humerus. Shoulder joint. Which joint? Shoulder joint.
That's clear? Now, go forward toward muscle. Ligaments marking, attachment marking means
these attachments, there is the muscles are attached. Okay.
The number one is the crest, you know.
Crest is what? This is the sharp ridged on the bone surface, a linear sharp ridged. For example, here, the best example, if you take for example,
look here, you know,
this is the one side of hip bone. Hip bone, actually three bones fuse together. So this bone, is this area is actually known as iliac bone. This is what?
Ilium.
So, ilium. So this is what? This, you know, this end, which we called as what? This is a ridge, sharp linear ridge. This is a sharp linear ridge. So this sharp linear ridge, they provide what? A site for attachment of the muscles. Muscles attach here. So this is known as what? Crest. Because here, if you are taking example of oscoxial hip bone, this will be known as iliac crest. This will be known as iliac crest. This will be known as
iliac crest.
The next one we have what?
Next one we have tuberosity.
You know, tuberosity is actually a rough area.
Which area?
A rough, roughed area, roughed region